We know COVID is dangerous to pregnant women. They have an increased risk of ending up in the intensive care unit. They have an increased risk of needing intubation. And you have to weigh that risk and your risk of acquiring COVID versus the potential theoretic risk of a vaccine. We now have animal data where they gave the vaccine to pregnant animals, and then they look at what happens to the embryos and the pups. We haven't seen any untoward effects. So far, everything we know is reassuring. Also, from the mechanism of how the vaccine works, overall, we feel reassured. So I think at this point, what we say to pregnant women is that it's a discussion you should have with your provider and look at your risks of acquiring COVID. What we think about mRNA is that it doesn't cross the placenta. We think that it's degraded very quickly by your body's own systems, which is partly why they have to surround it by fat particle in order to get it into your muscle and into your cells. The American Society of Reproductive Medicine published this, that we don't feel like there's any worry about fertility concerns. The vaccine stays, the mRNA stays mostly local in the lymph nodes. It doesn't really travel through the bloodstream very much. We don't think that it will impact the eggs or the implantation or things like that. We are recommending that lactating women consider the vaccine, depending on their risk factors. We don't have any reason to fear harm in the babies of lactating women. Again, studies are going to be starting for looking at the transmission of the COVID antibodies after you get the vaccine through the breast milk. We don't have that data yet, but we do not have any concerns, nor does the American Academy of Pediatrics. I feel like the more risks you have for how dangerous the disease will be for you when you acquire COVID, to me, that makes more sense to get the vaccine. And so if I were talking to my own patient, you know, I would be listening to that patient and trying to assess how they were feeling about the risk. But overall, if they had significant medical risk factors, I would be saying, you know, personally, I think this could be a really good idea for you because we absolutely know how dangerous COVID can be.